What is going on, everyone? It is Mike, and welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. If you're in the market for a keyboard for your 10.2-inch iPad and you want to have a good typing experience, you want to have backlit keys and an integrated trackpad, I might have found the perfect keyboard for you. This is the Combo Touch from Logitech, and it's available for the 10.2-inch iPad as well as the iPad Air 3. Now, as of this video, it is only available from the Apple Store, but I'll go ahead and make sure that there are links to anywhere else I go ahead and find this keyboard. Now, just so you and I are on the same page, this is not a paid review from Logitech. I bought this keyboard with my own money, and anything I talk about in the video will be linked in the video description below. Those links are going to be Amazon affiliate links, and if you end up buying something from them, Amazon pays me a small commission that doesn't cost you a thing. Any money that I earn ends up getting reinvested into the channel in terms of more products to review, so anything that you can do is much appreciated. Finding a good keyboard for the 10.2-inch iPad is not necessarily a difficult thing to do. You might even remember that last year I reviewed the Bridge keyboard for the 10.2-inch iPad, maybe in October or November, if I remember correctly. And at the time, it was really the most premium keyboard available for Apple's entry-level tablet. It was $130. It offered a good typing experience, it was designed nicely, and I think it was a win for a lot of people, but it did leave some things to be desired. Now enter the Combo Touch. If you're familiar with Logitech's keyboard cases, I would say that they're hallmarked by three design principles. First, the keyboards are going to have a comfortable typing experience that's going to appeal to a wide variety of different people based on how they type. Second, the keyboard is going to have a row of dedicated iOS function keys along the top, giving quick access to common functions. And third, the keyboard case itself is going to offer full protection for your iPad. Now, after using the Combo Touch for the past maybe 10 days, I would tell you that the keyboard delivers on all three of those design principles. Let's talk about the basics. The entire case is covered in a gray woven fabric, and it gives a really kind of pleasing experience. The sides of the case are wrapped in a gray rubber that complements the woven fabric. There are cutouts in all the right places, giving you quick access to the camera, microphone, and even the charging port. Now, along the back, you're going to find a hinge that allows for viewing angles to be adjusted anywhere from almost completely flat, I would say, to about 90 degrees. The hinge and the viewing angles play off one another, and they really are what enable the different contexts that the Combo Touch can be used in. You have type, view, sketch, and read. Unlike most keyboard cases that I've seen to date, the Combo Touch is going to be the first keyboard case here in the States connects to your iPad using the smart dock connector located on the bottom of your iPad. Now, this automatically pairs and powers that keyboard using that smart dock connector, and there are two direct benefits to you here. First, you don't need to worry about that cumbersome pairing and charging process that's associated with most Bluetooth keyboards that I'm sure you hate. Second, it allows for quick context switching from typing to sketching or any other of those contexts I mentioned a moment ago in just a matter of a few seconds. Now, as I alluded to in the beginning, the keyboard typing experience is pretty good. All right, I do like it a lot. It's going to be sufficient for most people that I think are considering the Combo Touch. First, the keys have a good amount of key travel. Here, let's just listen to this. Again, they sound good. This is a good sounding keyboard. Now, if you're rating keyboards on the way they sound, I would say that this is a good sounding keyboard. But there is a good amount of key travel here, and there are going to be 5 levels of backlight. Now, somewhat uniquely, Apple is giving keyboard manufacturers the ability to develop iPadOS apps to customize the keyboard experience, which is actually really neat. As soon as you go ahead and connect the Combo Touch to your iPad, you're prompted to download the companion app from the App Store, and inside this Logitech app, you can use it to modify the timeout duration and even the key brightness. Now, I don't know about you, but I'd really like to see a company like Logitech bring something wild to the iPad keyboard, like RGB lighting. That would be awesome. Logitech, let me know if you can make that happen. I'd be a fan. Now, across the top, you're going to find a full row of iOS function keys, which I'm a fan of. I do like these things because they really just kind of help facilitate easy actions. One button to bring you home, adjust the screen brightness up and down, bring up the virtual keyboard, search in iOS, change the key brightness up and down, media controls, rewind, fast forward, play, volume controls, and mute, in addition to a single button to go ahead and lock the iPad. In type mode, I think that really the biggest selling point is going to be the integrated trackpad found at the bottom of the keyboard. So the bottom 30% of the keyboard is where you're going to have that integrated trackpad. Now, if I'm looking at the size of the trackpad on the Combo Touch and comparing it against the Magic trackpad, it's really the same height, same size. There's really no difference from it. It actually feels exactly the same. Here's the trackpad. I'm going to give you a clickability score. That's because the integrated trackpad turns your iPad into a fully functional computer. I'm not joking here. I know there's people here that think iPadOS is a joke, but it turns your iPad into a fully functional computer simply by attaching this keyboard. Now, what's great is it gives you immediate access to all the great trackpad features that have come in iPadOS 13.4. Now, here, as I record this video, I have the Combo Touch in front of me. I have my Magic trackpad in front of me with my iPad, and all the same functions are available on either device. This means that whether I'm buying the $330 tablet or the $800 tablet, the keyboard that attaches to it functions exactly the same. If you're unfamiliar with gestures and how they work, or you really just want to refresh your memory, I'll go ahead and put a link in the video description above to a video that I did for 25 tips and tricks for the Magic Trackpad. Simply stated, I am a huge fan of the trackpad experience, maybe even more so than those iOS function keys, which is hard to believe. But I really, because it just changes the way that you work on the iPad. Now, using each one of these, like I said, you cannot tell the difference between the trackpad on the Combo Touch and that on the Magic Keyboard. So there's that. Depending on how you type, you might find the keys a little bit on the small side. Now, looking at this keyboard, the keys themselves, like the letter keys, are not any smaller than that on the Magic Trackpad, but it's all the keys that are around it. So, you know, all the function keys, the shift keys, those are all smaller than what they are on the Magic Trackpad. So that's where you might have some trouble. Like if you use the tilde a lot, this is going to be a little bit smaller. I would say this is actually probably the same size as the 11-inch Magic Keyboard. At the end of the day, you got to ask yourself, is it worth spending $150 on this keyboard case with the integrated trackpad? Well, you can think of it one of two different ways. If you don't already have a keyboard today, is there value in you buying this keyboard with the integrated trackpad? I think it's more valuable to have this versus buying a keyboard separately and Magic Trackpad 2, or even having a separate mouse. The experience with the gestures on the Magic Trackpad really make the best experience out there today. I would probably prioritize getting a trackpad over getting a mouse at this point. Now, it does have a good typing experience. Is it going to be a great experience for you? That's probably something that you'll have to let me know in the comments below. But otherwise, I think I would rather have an integrated trackpad with a keyboard, much like the Combo Touch. But let me know what you think about this in the comments below. Are you going to pick one up? Have you already picked it up? And if you have, do you plan to keep it? Now, I have a lot of other product reviews coming up for iPhones and iPads, so make sure you are subscribed with notifications so you can be alerted when that new content drops. I got the Bridge Pro Plus coming up very soon. I should have it in the next day or so. So get excited. We got more keyboards coming up. I am Mike. This is Tech 24/7 TV. Stay safe out there, folks.